Welcome to a hydronic heating system, radiant in-floor heating system, radiant heating system, a few different names, but it's all the same. You've got some major components with that. Number one, in this one, we have the boiler. This is a high efficiency modulating condensing boiler. Over here, we have a sidearm unit. This looks like a hot water heater, but the boiler makes all the hot water, not only the domestic for, you know, your shower, but it also makes all the hot water for the heat in the house. This is a holding tank for that hot water. It's called the sidearm unit. Up here we have the zone valves. This is the one maintenance piece for the boiler that you do need to know about. Some places you'll see these, it will be required by code. This is a condensation neutralizer. And the condensation coming out of the boiler is slightly acidic. This is used to neutralize it before it goes into the source system, because that acidic condensate can corrode copper and iron pipes, and we don't want that. It's also not good for the environment. This is something that needs to be serviced annually. It needs to be recharged or refilled with the neutralizing material. This is the boiler disconnect switch. It's going to shut the boiler off, required by code. So if someone has to do maintenance on it, they can shut that off and not have an electrical hazard. If you have no heat, make sure the switch is not in the off position. These are the zone valves. These are controlled individually by thermostats throughout the house. So if you count the number of zone valves, that's how many thermostats you'll have in the house. The way it works is you have a loop in each room, a loop of PEX piping that the hot water goes through. As you can see, it goes out through this pipe and returns through this pipe. And the valve will open and close to allow the hot water to go through that and return. So it'll go out hot, it'll heat the room and come back cooler. This is the zone valve here. You can visually see when the valve opens, the thermostat will drive it to the on position. They call this a see-feel indicator because you can see that it's on, but if the valve is in such a place that you can't see it, you can reach down and feel that it's on. If you have a valve, the thermostat's not working, the room is cold, and you need to manually, you'd like to manually open it, you can drive this over manually and then click it over like that, and that's on permanently until you fix the thermostat. Or you can come and close it back off. So you can run these manually if the thermostat is malfunctioning. That's pretty rare, but I just want you to be aware of that. This is an example of a thermostat that runs those zone valves I showed you. Pretty simple. You set the temperature you want. In this case, we have the garage set to 60 degrees. And then it will show the temperature of the room at this point now. And it will also indicate whether the heat is on or off. So there, heat on. On the high efficiency condensing modulating boiler, the boiler also takes into account the outside temperature to help make it more efficient, and that's the modulating feature of it. On the outside of the house, you will have the outside temperature sensor for the boiler. So a general point on a hydronic heating system, a lot of people that have these, they're in a second home, they want to turn the temperature down when they leave. A hydronic heating system, like this garage, for example, is heated. We have 300 feet of coil heating the concrete slab. There's literally tons of thermal mass that's being heated. If you turn that down to 50 degrees, you come up on the weekend and you turn the temperature back up, it's going to take 24 to 48 hours minimum to see an increase in temperature. So in a hydronic heating system, they're super efficient. You want to just find a comfortable temperature and leave it there, because you'd have to turn it up 2 or 3 days before you come to bring the house up to a comfortable temperature.